welcome to KwaZulu-Natal, South Africa's beautiful province. Join us on a beautiful trip as we go around the province to different locations. We're starting here in Durban, as you can see the backdrop behind me. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the trip. Upon arrival from any direction and by any mode of transportation, it's not difficult to see why Vasco da Gama decided to stop here almost 7 centuries ago, as historians like to think that it was because he found shelter from the Indian Ocean storms at sea. Named after the famous Zulu king Shaka Gadini Zulu, we set off at Ushaka Marine World and explore this world-class leisure and entertainment facility. There's not enough time in a day to enjoy just half of what Durban has to offer. From beautiful shorelines to authentic Indian cuisine to a beautiful, reliable climate that makes Durban the mecca of a city that lives in the outdoors and has been dubbed South Africa's playground. We are joined by one of the most powerful and probably the most busiest people around in South Africa as far as tourism is concerned. Sir, would you introduce yourself, please?
Hi, I'm Gavin Castleman. I'm Chief Executive Officer of Gooderson Leisure Corporation. We're now a national company based in the three main provinces, Gauteng, KwaZulu-Natal, where we're based at our head office, and Limpopo province.
Now, Gooderson Group is one of the largest tourism groups in the country. And from what you just mentioned now, with all the facilities that are around, how many of them are actually enough to cater for families or family-orientated facilities?
A little bit in time. Gooderson Leisure was founded in 1959 by Alan Gooderson, who's our current chairman, by his father. So it's second generation family business. We are currently listed on the Altex, so we are on the stock exchange. So we're a listed company now. We're no longer a private company. We like to call ourselves a mixed-use resort company. We have a number of properties. If I start in KwaZulu-Natal, where we are right now, we've got Drakensberg Gardens, which is based in the Underberg area, which is a large resort which caters for families. We've got all sorts of facilities on site in this. We can get into details on that one later. Our Underberg resort, which we recently acquired, is Monk's Cowl, which is in the central Drakensberg. We're currently in the process of building 18 more rooms at that resort now at the moment. We've got Tropicana Hotel, which is based on the Durban beachfront, where our head office is based as well. And then when we move up the coast slightly, up the north coast, we've got two lodges. We've got Dumazulu, which is a traditional village, which is in the picture right behind us, and Bushland's Game Lodge, which is a lodge with game on the property. No big five, unfortunately, but it's sort of the buck type animals. And a little bit further, when we come back towards Durban, we've got Mpinzini Forest Lodge, which is it's a timeshare resort at this stage, based in the forest of Mpinzini. In the Limpopo province, we have a hotel out there, and one in Lone Hill, in the center of Joburg, or close to the center of Joburg, and then Kloppenheim, which is out in the Machadodorp area. So we have a wide spread of resorts, but it's multi-use, where we have timeshare and hotels. We develop timeshare as well. That's part of our portfolio. So we're quite broad in terms of where we are in the hotel industry, the hospitality industry. I forgot Natal Spa, which is also one of our resorts out in the Port Petersburg area. Our resort hotels are the ones which cater for the families. Natal Spa is very family orientated. We have hot springs here, we have water slides, we've got horse rides, quad bikes. So we've got a number of activities there which cater for families. Drakensberg Gardens is set up for families, the ideal resort, from everything from bowls to tennis to squash to horse riding to... The list is endless. We've just put in a heated pool recently.
With the facilities that you just mentioned, and like I said, I went through your website and I've actually looked for myself, taken a couple of brochures. Now, with the rates, that looks rather interesting because it's really affordable. Now, why would you want to do this where everybody else tends to be a little bit more expensive?
At Gooderson Leisure, we say we're a good value, good fun company, and that's what we try and promote with our rates. And our rates are very, very, very competitive and we feel very good value for money, and we package a lot of our rates. So you can go on holiday and have a dinner, bed, breakfast package with sometimes golf thrown into your package. So we really like to package and make it good value, good fun. That's where we like to stand as a company.
With the affordable rates that you mentioned and the facilities that cater for the families, one might say that as Gooderson Leisure Group, you've clearly done all that you can do. You've reached the sky. So where to from here?
Yeah, we're always looking for acquisitions. The market is right now for acquisitions. As I said to you earlier, Monk's Cowl was our most recent acquisition. We only got that last year, December. When the right properties come up, we are looking for opportunities to develop the brand, which obviously is important to us, the Gooderson Leisure brand, and to get a wider scope of properties across the country.
Fantastic. Gavin, thank you so much for your time.
Pleasure. Thank you very much. Yeah.
Good morning once again. It is our first day. We're leaving Durban this time around. We're going up north. It is a bit of a chilly Durban morning. As you can see, I've got my beanie on, so stay with us. We are just hitting the N3, just going through the historical sites of Durban, Soldiers Way. That's when the 1820 soldiers came this way and they went past here. That's why this area is called Soldiers Way. But today it's got a McDonald's, so it's different. So hunger soldiers are there at McDonald's. So we're heading out of Durban to 1,000 Hills. Beautiful area, really fantastic.
Our compass and GPS both concurred that traveling in a northern direction is the best idea. 30 miles just outside of Durban lies a breathtaking landscape that has fascinated travelers and locals alike. The Valley of 1,000 Hills.
You can see we are now in the location where we say we're going to, which is the Valley of 1,000 Hills. As you can see right behind me, it's just hill after hill after hill as far as the eye could see. One of the most beautiful sights and beautiful sceneries here in KwaZulu-Natal. It's just outside of, we're just outside of Durban now, just above Hillcrest, which we call a Valley of 1,000 Hills, on our journey, of course, to the north.
Erosion over hundreds of thousands of years has carved this landscape to what we see today. An absolute paradise for hikers, outdoor photographers, water sport fanatics, and for those who want to witness this wonder.
Well, we are at Dumazulu Lodge, and we're joined here by one of the lodge managers, or the only lodge manager, that's Heinz Fritz. Heinz, tell us about Dumazulu, just briefly, for those who are not sure.
Dumazulu is very authentic. It's a very nice lodge based around the Zulu culture. Mm. It's got different rooms representing different tribes. And what makes us unique with the other lodges are, is the location, first of all, and the fact that we're very versatile. We a very, how can I say it, unique lodge with a difference. Meaning that you experience Zulu culture and it's balanced within hospitality, if you get what I'm saying, the spirit of Ubuntu.
Fantastic, fantastic. And now I see that there's quite a bit of development taking place here. What are your plans?
Definitely, definitely. Development is always good. We're busy building a bird aviary. It's about 3,800 square meters.
Great.
It's a free flight aviary. It's going to be elevated walks, canopy tour, and then as well as a bottom tour incorporated to the snake and croc box, which we also upgraded with amphibians. Another thing that's also going to be added on later on phase two, we're going to look future wise, is introduce the raptor spark.
Fantastic.
Where you get the birds of prey, that sort of scenario.
All right, fantastic. That was Heinz Fritz from Dumazulu Lodge and one of the managers. So make sure that when you are here, you ask to see this gentleman. Absolute legend.
Thank you.
We're still here at Dumazulu. This is the
best time of the day as far as I'm concerned. As you can see, my face is still a little bit waking up. We're about to head for breakfast and we've got a beautiful day ahead of us. We're going to do a game drive. It's going to be, the weather is beautiful. As I've had a look outside, it's going to be absolutely fantastic. But the first thing, let's go top up our stomachs. Well, welcome again. You just joined us after the breakfast. We are now at Hlahlwe Umfolozi Park and we're going to be taking a bit of a game drive. It's one of the things you got to do when you come to Africa. It is almost like heaven. You have to do it. So join us as we take through and hopefully we'll see the big five. So come with us.
Gentlemen, good morning. Welcome to Hlahlwe Umfolozi Game Reserve. This park is about 960 square kilometers in size, or about 96,000 hectares, just to give you a rough idea. This park was established in 1895. It's the oldest park on the African continent, and it's the second oldest in the world, just next to the Yellowstone, or just after the Yellowstone in the USA, I believe, yes. We do have the big five here. Please help me find them, right? Just to give you a bit of a background, the park. This park's very familiar for saving the white rhino species from extinction. There were in the 1920s there were about 20 rhino left at that time. The last surviving 20 rhino were all in this park. So this park took the opportunity. They conserved and they saved the white rhino species from extinction. They were very successful. By the 1960s, this park was overpopulated with the rhino species. They had to eventually capture these animals and then translocated them to other parks around the continent. Today there's about 2,300 white rhino in this park, roughly. There's a black rhino species as well, but only about 200. Yes. And sit back, relax and enjoy, see what we can find and have fun.
All right, we've got everything sorted out, our formalities for our game drive. A big thank you to JJ, who's going to be our game driver. So we're about to head off. Hopefully we'll be able to see the big five. Let's go.
Three hours north of Durban will see you land a few miles away from the world's second oldest game reserve, Hlahlwe Umfolozi Park. Nestled in the north coast, less than 7 miles from the game reserve, lies Duma Zulu Cultural Village, which offers a reflection into how the Zulu tribe lived centuries ago, long before even King Shaka was born. From then till now, very little has changed in the lifestyles of locals who voluntarily choose to live this way. Someone once said, "When nature calls, you must respond." So I decided to do the one thing you must do when in Hlahlwe, and that is to go on the game drive. We were in luck with the African elephants as they came in droves, some a little too close for comfort, as the only thing separating us and them was the windscreen shield of our game van.
This is the African elephant, the largest species of the two that you find in the world. The African elephant, that's their name, not only because they live here and come from Africa, but if you look at the shape of the ears, it looks like the shape of the African continent, or it's in the shape of the African continent. That's why they are called the African elephant. This is a small breeding herd, mostly made up of females and the offspring, which got young males with them, and they will be the largest one of them all will be the matriarch.
Okay, we are in absolute luck. As you can see here, the elephants have come up to Mapumulo picnic site, and it looks like they're also coming up for a picnic. Take a look. Thank you.
Dumazulu Cultural Village has some rather slimy residents. And no, I'm not referring to the staff or guests, but serpents. For the less squeamish, the snake park and the snake show must be on your to-do list. For me, it was a close encounter that I would prefer not to do again in the near or far future.
Okay, this is probably one of the most difficult things I've ever had to do. We're back from seeing the big five, and now we're actually going to see some snakes. Right next to me here is Gareth, and he's a snake handler. As you can see, he's got something around his neck. Hello, Gareth.
Hi, how are you?
I've seen better times. How are you doing?
All right, and yourself?
Good, thank you. Tell us, what do you have around your neck?
Well, this little guy around me over here is actually quite a harmless constrictor. It's not an indigenous snake to South Africa. It's what they call a red-tailed boa.
Okay.
This is still a very, very young one. It will get much, much bigger.
Okay.
You feel that?
Yeah, it feels great.
Yeah, one of the most common things that people always say when they look at snakes is they say they're slimy. You can feel it is a bit slimy. Okay, it's a cold day today, so that the snakes do tend to take on the environmental temperature, so it is a bit cool. But, I mean, it's not biting me, it's not trying to kill me. It's just happy to be out here.
Okay, so I mean, no danger whatsoever being this close?
No, absolutely. Not at all. Nothing at all.
All right, fantastic. All right, tell us what other snakes we're going to go through.
Well, we've got a couple of nice selection of snakes here for you guys. We're going to take out a couple of the venomous ones.
Okay.
And what we've chosen is puff adders because of their wide distribution in South Africa.
All right.
And then we've got a nice little snouted cobra that we're going to pull out for you guys. And if that all works out quite well, black mamba. And the reason we've chosen a black mamba is just to show you guys that their hype and their reputation is a little bit undeserved as well.
Okay, all right. Speaking of undeserved, I think I'm going to let you watch a bit more snake handling. I don't deserve to be here, so I'm going to get out of here and let Gareth do his thing. All right, we've moved on to the worst part, into the better part. I've always told you that I'm the crocodile dandy, and this is why.
For the absolute nature lover, we took a mile drive to the neighboring Bushlands Lodge, a breathtaking establishment which boasts wooden cabins suspended a couple of feet from the ground, giving you an ultimate Bushlands getaway. As a city slicker, I found that Dumazulu Cultural Village and Bushlands Lodge are the meccas of serenity, the ultimate destination for those who seek true peace of mind.
Right, I trust that you enjoyed the last couple of our visits, in fact, to the big five and the crocodiles and the snakes. Now we're coming to the most important part about Dumazulu Cultural Village. We're going to go through the cultural show and let's see what they're up to behind.
The golden brown winter grasslands of the Highveld invaded our sight as we made our way to the extreme northeastern side of KwaZulu-Natal. Crackling radio signal, long stretches of the road as far as the eye could see, and slowly running out of small talk conversation in the car, it is these grasslands that somewhat kept us company for a few hours.
We
we discovered a one-of-a-kind site kept secret by many, the Natal Hot Springs and Spa.
We're finally here, that's at the Natal Hot Springs and Spa in the northern side of KZN. It's been quite an interesting journey, as you've seen on the videos, but this is where it gets really, really, really absolutely the best. There's a lot of activities to do here, and of course the most famous thing about these hot springs is that they naturally aspired. The hot water, or the warm water, comes from the ground up. So come with me as we take a look at what else is there to do here.
For those who want to remain out of the water for a moment, there's an endless list of activities to do. I tried my luck at golf. Okay, maybe not golf, but putt-putt. That was so exhausting. I had to stop by at the water fountain. Not just any water fountain, the local bar.
Alright, this is the exciting part for me. It is the quad biking. As you can see, I've got my material on, I've got my equipment ready, I've got my shades on. Let's go!
The hot springs are nestled and shielded away from plain sight, and for one to truly see the beauty of this area, you'll have to go on all fours. A quick crash course and I was good to go. Much to my surprise, the quad bike course route is friendly to riders of all ages. So we rode for miles, 10 miles to be exact, and we were chasing daylight back at the springs. The full course will keep you busy the entire day. A fantastic ending to a great day. The order of events for the evening, well, shower, eat, socialize. In the morning, sunlight pierced through my room window as if to say, "Good morning, sunshine." The air is cleaner and clearer in this countryside, even in the heart of winter. After topping our stomachs, we caught up with Ryan, who told us more about the hot springs.
We're at the Natal Spa and Resort here in Paul Petersburg, and we're very fortunate to be joined by the general manager, and that's of course Ryan Smith. Welcome, Ryan.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you for the opportunity.
Tell us a bit more about the Natal Spa.
We're a hot springs resort. We're set in the heart of the KZN bushveld. Mm-hmm. We're well known for our hot spring mineral water, which we are very, very proud of. We're a resort which offers a little bit for everybody, a little bit for moms, dads and the kids. If you're looking for accommodation, on the accommodation side, we offer hotel rooms, self-catering accommodation. If you want to camp, you can camp here with us. And we also have a little bit of timeshare on the resort as well for those that are interested in a bit of timeshare.
So that's fantastic. So it's literally an all-in-one package.
All-in-one package is everything to do here that you could possibly think of.
Yes.
If there's something you need with regards to cooking, or if you're a camper and you've left something at home, you have a little shop here on the resort. And there's everything, absolutely everything to do here.
Fantastic. Now tell us, what's it this particular spa, apart from other spas around KZN, in terms of probably what is available around here?
Well, most importantly, we can't leave out the hot water. Our spring water is naturally heated. No artificial heating or chemicals goes into our hot water, which, you know, no doubt is that's why the water is famous for its healing powers.
Fantastic.
We do have examples of our water healing people in many different ways, which is, I think, the biggest draw card for us here at Natal Spa. Besides that, we have probably the cleanest air and water in South Africa. Natal Spa and Paul Petersburg has, I think, notched a sentence in one of the Guinness Book of World Records in the past as having the cleanest water and the cleanest air. We have beautiful bird life here, and most especially and most importantly our crown eagles,
right,
which successfully breed on a yearly basis.
Sure.
We have a fair amount of rock art on the resort. Mm-hmm. Our sand visitors back in the day,
yes,
were here before, so you know they've left some yes, history behind.
Wow.
So I think that sets us apart from quite a lot of spas in South Africa. We're easily accessible. We're off the main road. We're not hard to find. So
that is great.
Yeah.
Great. So that was Ryan Smith, general manager of the Natal Hot Springs and Spa. Next time, I'll definitely be bringing my fishing rod because I need to try out some fishing as well as horse riding. From the Natal Hot Springs and Spa, we move on to our next location. Stay with us. We just left the Natal Hot Springs and Spa, that's in Paul Petersburg. We just took a stop over here at Altijd Sommer Farm Store. Basically what it means is that it's always summer, even in winter. So we're gonna pack our bags with all these goodies, which are homemade by the way, truly South African, and then hit the road. So come with us while we choose our groceries for the road.
What will the Zulu Kingdom be without Izindaba Zokahlamba, also known as the Drakensberg Mountains? These mountain ranges stretch over three provinces and serve as a natural border fence between South Africa and Lesotho. This World Heritage Site boasts ancient rock paintings done by the true indigenous people of the area, the Sand People, which dates back thousands of years, way before Nguni tribes moved to the area. We got settled at the foot of the mountains, where this was our home for a day or two.
All right, we're finally here. That's a Drakensberg Spa and a golf resort. It's been a long drive. Thank you. We're gonna check out a couple of things to do around here. We're also gonna meet Peter Mule, the hotel manager. So let's find out what they have for us.
Welcome to Drakensberg Gardens.
After freshening up, we caught up with Peter Mule, the general manager of the resort, to tell us a bit more about this fantastic establishment.
All right, we're at our next stop. That's, of course, the Drakensberg Golf Resort. Beautiful area. It's a very nice place to chill. I've got a very good friend of mine here and also happens to be the general manager of this whole entire beautiful place. And, of course, Peter Mule.
Gabriel, lovely to have you with us again.
Thank you so
Always
much.
Always a pleasure.
Thank you so mighty much. Now, Peter, quickly, just tell us for the viewers, really, what facilities do you have around here?
Well, we've got a huge property, Gabriel. It's 860 hectares. And I think what our goal here is that anyone who comes here, whether it be for a weekend or for 7 days, no one ever gets bored. You've got your 18-hole golf course, which is the only 18-hole golf course in the southern Drakensberg. We have some very successful tournaments here. We've got horse riding. We've got a mountain bike trail inside the property and a good 70, 80 kilometers of mountain bike trail outside the property. There's tennis, bowls, squash. We've got 4 kilometers of river. We've got hiking trails that stretch up all over the mountains, whether they be inside the property or outside. And we do an organized hike up the Rhino Peak, which is right behind us up there. You got to be a little bit fitter than me, I think, to do that.
Just tell us the dam that we're sitting on now. Can you go fishing? And this, what can you do?
This is a man-made dam. It's one of the places where I unfortunately do hit a lot of golf balls into. You can see there's a couple of chaps on your left-hand side throwing some rods. We do stock this dam with trout, and the guys are quite successful. They catch some lovely trophies here. And we've got the paddle boats, and it's just really a beautiful feature to add on to the clubhouse and just the visual aspect of the hikes and the mountain bike trail around the resort. We have a full wellness center where we do a range of treatments, open from 8 o'clock in the morning till 10 o'clock at night. Massages, hot stone massages, facials, manicures, pedicures, all those kinds of things. And we have a full, fully equipped gym that has a sauna, jacuzzis, and a steam bath in it.
Fantastic. You know what, Peter? Thank you so much for your time. What I'm going to do, I'm actually going to try out the spa first, and then I'm going to have a look at all the other facilities around here. Maybe actually come and knock a round or two of golf as well a little bit later. Thank you so much for your time, Peter.
I'll see you on the course, Gabriel.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
And that's where we wrap it up, and I'm going to continue to actually have a look around here and really take it easy, put my feet up, and relax. Now, the one thing that is beautiful about the Drakensberg Gardens Golf Resort is that you don't have to take the gym with you wherever you go. In fact, they have a gym. So I'm going to burn off some of the calories that I have picked up along the way, as you can see.
this beautiful, lovely setup. As usual, water bottle, never forget it. And of course, your sweat towel. It's just considerate that when you're done using the equipment, should your sweat drip, you wipe it off. All right, off you go. I'm gonna do my workout. Oops.
To truly enjoy the facilities around and also get a taste of what the Basutu people less than 2 miles over the mountains use as their mode of transport, I decided to give this a try.
All right, so I'm about to do one of the things that since I was 12 years old, I'll say I will never do again. That's riding a horse. I couldn't resist here at the Drakensberg Spa and Golf Resort. So I'm gonna try it again, 21 years down the road. Let's see if I still got it.
One of the saddest moments is driving away from the mountain as you depart. Every glance on the rearview mirror, I could almost see the mountain waving, becoming smaller and smaller, and eventually disappearing entirely.
Well, we're at Moses Mabhida Stadium and we're literally moving up in the world. We're in the sky car. We're gonna take a good shot, a good look at Durban and what it looks like from right at the top of the arch. Stay with us.
We've seen quite a few places here in KwaZulu-Natal over the last couple of days. And thank you very much for staying with us. We're ending off on a high. We are now on the viewing platform here at Moses Mabhida Stadium. A big thank you to all the support that we got from our sponsors. That's the Gooderson Leisure Group out of all the areas that we visited. Not forgetting Nissan. That's of course Dart Center Nissan in Pietermaritzburg. And also East Coast Radio for being such good citizens or business citizens here in Durban. We hope that you enjoyed this video, and of course the man behind it all who does every single job, Chris Duplessis from Photos of Africa. Thank you to everybody who was involved. We hope to see you soon.